Welcome to the spoken tutorial on connecting SBHS to computer. We would call single board heater system as SBHS in this tutorial. In this spoken tutorial, we will learn to set up physical communication between SBHS and computer, to install USB driver. To work with SBHS, we would require SBHS with power cable and USB or RS232 communication cable. On a Windows machine, we would also require FTDI virtual COM port USB driver corresponding to the operating system on your computer. You may download it from www.ftdichip.com/drivers/vcp.htm. Let me show you this website. On this website, scroll down and choose the driver file corresponding to your operating system. I have downloaded 32-bit 2.08.14 driver file for Windows. The single board heater system and your computer can be connected using a USB cable or RS232 cable. Identify the corresponding ports on your computer and SBHS. Here is an image of the USB port you will find on the back panel of a computer. A serial port on the computer back panel. USB and serial port on the SBHS. Please note that before deciding to use RS232 cable, confirm the availability of RS232 port on your computer. After you choose between USB and the serial cable, you have to do some corresponding jumper settings. A jumper is just a small black color connector. A pair of these is shown here. Each jumper can connect two terminals. The connectors on SBHS with both the jumpers removed is as shown in this figure. Here we can see that there are three terminals on either side. We can also see the labels USB and RS232 being printed besides these connectors on the PCB. The center terminal on either side is the common terminal. Take a jumper and connect the common terminal of one side and the terminal closer to the label USB of the same side. Take another jumper and do the same thing for the other side. This is how you set the jumpers to choose the USB port for communication. Similarly, one can put both the jumpers on common terminal and the terminal towards the label RS232 to choose RS232 port for communication. I have configured the jumper settings to choose USB port as shown. After the jumper setting is done, connect the power cable to a 3-pin 230 volt AC household socket and the SBHS. Switch the mains power on. There may or may not be an on-off switch on the SMPS of the SBHS below the power cable connector. If the device is successfully powered, the display should turn on. Here is an image of the display on SBHS. Note that what is actually seen on the display may vary from what is shown, but it should certainly not be blank. After powering on the SBHS, connect the appropriate USB or RS232 cable to the SBHS and the computer. Here is an illustration of USB cable connected to SBHS and the laptop. Always make sure that you first power on the device and then connect the USB or RS232 cable. Next, we will see driver installation. Recall that the FTDI VCP USB driver was downloaded earlier from ftdichip.com. You can also find here a guide for driver installation. Download the guide from www.ftdichip.com. Let us go to this website. In the left panel, click on drivers. In the drop-down menu, choose VCP drivers. Click on the installation guides link on the web page. Choose the required operating system document. Since I am using Windows 7 operating system, I have referred to Windows 7 installation guide. You may choose the operating system guide according to your requirement. This guide has detailed step-by-step instructions for driver installation. Let me show you the Windows 7 PDF guide file. Follow the steps as explained in this guide and install the driver. The typical steps involved are: opening the device manager, locating the USB port, putting the driver path, and repeating the steps once more. Once the driver is successfully installed, you should get the device listed under COM and LPT. Let me show you this over here. Your device should also get a COM number. Here, for example, it is shown as COM3. Now let us summarize what we learned in this tutorial. First is, connect the SBHS and computer. This involves choosing RS232 or USB port, jumper settings, powering on the SBHS. Second, install USB driver, downloading the installation guide, following the guide and installing the driver. Watch the video available at http://spoken-tutorial.org/what-is-a-spoken-tutorial. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, please write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT, MHRD, Government of India. More information on this mission is available at http://spoken-tutorial.org/NMEICT-intro. Thanks for joining. This is Rupak Rokade from IIT Bombay signing off. Goodbye.